off for Texas. It's May 1928, and here are close-ups of some beauties going to contest in the Lone Star State. This is Isabel Waldner, Miss Greater New York, pretty as her pearls by standards of 1928. Here's Dorothy Britton, Miss Universe of 27. Both seem confident of winning the Texas trial. Another leading contender for beauty crown is Mary Diasco, already enthroned as prettiest girl in Connecticut. Another beauty is Winifred Watson, already a prize winner as Miss Empire State of 1928.
Aptly called Girl Panic, watch as Naomi Campbell, Cindy Crawford, Helena Christensen, and more 90s mega models. Channel their inner rock stars, taking over London's posh. Savoy Hotel, in rocking out on stage and off.
In the early days of finery for chorus girls, every stage show boasted of a chorus a la Floridora. And the wide hats were not only the fashion, they filled the stage with something anyway. Here are the famous Tumble Sisters, popular circuit performers and quick change artists. Last one out of her long underwear is a sissy. First one out is a contortionist. Are they really changing costumes, or are they just putting on carbon copies of what they've taken off? Who knows?
Guys, watch yourself.
Watch yourself.
Move out of the way. Please give us some room.
Stand by to send Katie.
Katie's traveling. I need the band in position.
Send Katie now.
Well, anyway, here's what the change was for. And those things they're wearing aren't headpieces, they're headaches. Even aspirin couldn't cure.
It's the morning of the show. When I put on those wings, I just know I'm gonna feel magical.
There's Chanel. It's all about her wings.
Chanel walking first with Akon Singing Angel.
America's loveliest girl, 5 feet 6 inches tall, weight 127 pounds. Viennese artist who found her calls her a real daughter of the gods.
The mystique of Thin began with the arrival of the British model Twiggy in the late 1960s. Standing 5 feet 6 inches tall, she weighed only 91 pounds and was dubbed Britain's top mini model. Now a plus-size icon, Kate Dillon started out as a skinny model.
I think it happens to everybody at some point where you feel one way about yourself and that your intuition about who you are is that you're a good person, that you're beautiful, that you're strong, that you're capable. And then at some point, it's met with an outside force that's telling you no, you're none of those things.
Among young women, they're increasingly tuned in to a celebrity culture where the models and actresses' bodies are considerably thinner than they have ever been in the past. This is very seductive and hard for young girls to resist. This is not about illness. This is about idealized beauty and perfection of a certain type.
Big models in skimpy lingerie. Is this new ad too revealing for network TV? Lane Bryant added heat to the catwalk in Sin City, staging its first fashion show in nearly a decade. Ashley thinks advertising is reflecting a more honest view of women.
Things are changing. People are really just accepting curves and accepting what the average woman is.
Why, heaven help the working girl. It's around the turn of the century, and here are a few of the girls who helped turn the wheels of industry. Women, it seems, suddenly preferred a place of business instead of a place in the home. Those aren't 90s, they're street clothes. Professional dress designer by profession, Miss Clerk designed the smocks her fellow office workers are wearing. Yes, in 1926, Louise Clerk was hailed as a beauty with brains.
Princess stays true to herself, even when it's hard and everyone else doubts her. What do you think?
You know that flapping thing you were doing with your mouth just then?
You mean expressing my opinion?
Yeah, that. No more of that.